Greetings once again to all the regions of the Denver Church of Christ. My name is John Lusk, and I serve as the lead evangelist here. We're getting excited about our upcoming annual special missions offering on May 17th. To help us prepare our hearts and minds to give our very best on that day, I'm sharing a short series of videos called Mission Minutes. Each installment focuses on a different mission field that will be directly helped by your special offering. Last week, I talked about the 12 churches in the Mekong Peninsula of Southeast Asia, specifically Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, and Vietnam. This week, I want to focus on the complete opposite side of the world, but no less of a mission field, the Rocky Mountain churches. The Rocky Mountain region is comprised of over 1,000 disciples in Albuquerque, Fort Collins, Cheyenne, Colorado Springs, Grand Junction, and Denver. Two other churches are also seriously considering joining us at the present time. One of those is the church in Salt Lake City, and they'll actually be coming to our upcoming married retreat, so please reach out to them as much as you can. The church in Albuquerque and Colorado Springs are presently self-supporting, but the churches in Fort Collins and Grand Junction are not quite there. Since part of our special missions offering will be going to the church in Fort Collins, Cheyenne, and Grand Junction, let me share a little bit about them. First, Fort Collins and Cheyenne. As you may know, the Denver Church of Christ started the church in Fort Collins and also the church in Cheyenne many years ago. Presently, they meet all together as one congregation in Fort Collins, with the group in Cheyenne being more like a house church that comes in for Sunday services. We're so thankful for the leadership of Hans and Ann Rasmussen that they provided for those churches over the past 9 years. Presently, the church is led by Mike and Jody May and is discipled by Rob and Don Ferry. Their total membership is just over 60 disciples. Now, one of the greatest outreach opportunities in Fort Collins is also one of their greatest obstacles to building a larger self-sustaining church, and that is their universities. They convert a good number of college students, but many of them struggle to find great jobs in Fort Collins after graduating, and they end up having to move to Denver or other larger cities to find employment. Thus, they don't add long-term membership and finances to the church. So until the church there is able to build their strong adult ministries large enough and strong enough to sustain themselves, they need the support of the Denver church. Our leadership team here in Denver feels strongly that we don't want to spread the gospel to other areas if we're not taking care of the areas that we presently have on board. In recent years, several of our members in Denver have moved to Fort Collins to help strengthen that church, which has indeed helped significantly. $20,000 of our special missions offering will be going directly to help strengthen and spread the work in the mission field of Fort Collins and Cheyenne. Finally, Grand Junction. This is our newest planting in the Rocky Mountains. We're attempting to figure out a new way to create churches in smaller cities that really don't justify the cost of sending a full-time minister in the beginning. This will in turn allow us to plant many more churches like it all over the United States. Grand Junction was such a planting. 13 faithful, heroic disciples from Denver and Colorado Springs went there 9 months ago. Denver provides the financial support for two part-time ministers leading the campus work, Max and Shelby, who were raised up at CU. And we also provide video sermons that they show during their church services. Since they started, they've had one baptism and one restoration, but presently they have four people who are hoping to be baptized this month. For the past 9 months, Chris and Becky Clausen have been discipling the church, but we just recently made a change, and now Hans and Ann Rasmussen will be doing so. Brian and Christina Campbell will be discipling the campus work. $25,000 of our special missions offering will be going to help strengthen and spread the work in the mission field of Grand Junction. In addition to your sacrificial giving on May 17th, there's some other ways that you can help the mission field in Fort Collins, Cheyenne, and Grand Junction. One, pray for them. Two, visit those churches and serve them, encourage them. Three, consider moving there to help build these churches stronger. So remember, our special missions offering on May 17th. Our goal is to give well beyond $240,000, or approximately 8 times our weekly contribution amount. Some may not be able to give that much. Some may be able to give well more than that. As Paul says in 2 Corinthians 8:7, let's all excel in the grace of giving. I love you guys.